Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to the channel. Now in this video, I will show you how you can add a UI stack view, a background color. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay, I hope you didn't really know that a UI stack view doesn't have a background color property. So today I'm going to show you how you can create an extension to add a background color to a UI stack view. So let's jump right into it and let us just create a brand new Xcode project. And let me just close this off. I will create a single view application and name this UI stack view color. So UI stack view background color. Okay, let's click on next and I will drop it into here and I will create a Git repository because you will be able to find this project on my GitHub repo. Go ahead and click the link down below to get the resources. Great. Now that we have this, I'm going to create a UI stack view and place it on our root view controller. And so for that, I will use tiny constraints just to be on the fast side. So what we need to do now is go ahead and go to our root folder of our project, hit open up terminal and type in cd and the space as usual, drag and drop your folder there, hit return, type in pod in it first of all, because we want to initialize our pod file, then we are going to use pod install once we add our pods to our pod file. So let's just drag and drop it onto the Xcode icon. Let's remove this and add iOS 12 and type in here pod tiny constraints. Okay, so that's that. And finally, let's go back to our terminal and type in pod install. Now, this might be a real overkill, as one of my commenters stated, we could just simply use the basic old Apple provided layout constraints, but I hope that by using tiny constraints all of the time, you get to enjoy and love tiny constraints as much as I do, because in a much larger project, they are a lifesaver. So let's just limit this to 4.0.0. So I will go to back to our pod file and type in, there we go, and maybe hit pod install again so we can see that everything worked out okay. So this is our pod file. Okay, next up, we want to open up our Xcode workspace. So let's do that. Let me just size this so you can see everything as it should be. Okay, and now we are going to create a UI stack view programmatically. So let's jump into our root view controller and let's start off by creating a lazy variable, lazy var, and that will be, let's name this, not a real fantastic name for this one, but nonetheless, it does what it needs to do. So UI stack view and equals, and let's initialize it. And here, let's type in let, like stack view, and let it be a UI stack view, and let's return this stack view. Great, and that is it. Okay, let's hit command B so we may get rid of all of these errors, and yes we did. Now let's import tiny constraints because now I want to basically constrain our tutorial stack view. What we want to do here is create a new function like setup views. As usual, if you are familiar to my channel, I always create a file private func called, like that, func setup views, where I set up all of the views in my view controller. And first of all, I set the view's background color. So this is the view controller's view. And we set the background color, let's set it to plain old white. Okay, next up, I want to add this tutorial stack view to our view. So view.addSubView and tutorial stack view. And finally, I want to constrain it in some sort of way. So I will just add it to the top. And let's see now, let it be stack tutorial stack view dot top to super view, and I will use an offset of 36 here, and maybe let's use using safe area as true. Okay, there we go. Now let's constrain it to the left. So tutorial stack view left to left to super view. There we go. Offset, well, let's add in 12, and again using safe area. Okay, let's get rid of this so we may see a lot more code. Next up, I want to just simply copy this out. Oh, sorry, not committing, copying, command C. Okay, let's paste that in there, and I'm just simply add this to right and minus 12. Finally, we want to have our tutorial stack view's height set to, let's say, 50. That will be okay. Great. So let's start by simply adding a background color to our stack view, but that will not work. So let me just type in here stack view dot background color equals dot red. Okay, and now let's just build and run, and you will see that basically nothing will show up here. And that is because, first of all, we don't have any stack views, any views added to our stack view. So let's add two views here. Lazy var blue view, it will be a UI view. So let view equals UI view, and I will just add our view a background color of dot blue. Okay, and then we return our view, and let's not forget to initialize it. Now let's create a purple view, rather yet, let's create a green view here. Green, and the background color will be green. Great. Now let's just comment this out for now, and let's add these views to our stack view. So stack view, add range subview. And first of all, let's add our blue view. There we go. And then stack view, add arrange subview, our green view. Okay, now let's build and run and see how we are getting through the project till now. There we go, we have our blue view. And that is because we need to set some other properties too. And first thing that we need to set is our distribution. So let's just do that under here. Stackview.distribution. And I believe it's fill equally that we need to have here. Fill equally. Yes, that is it. And maybe let's set the stack views axis, and let it be, let's say, horizontal. And finally, I want to have our stack view spacing to be, let's say, let it be 5 pixels or points. so we can see that. Okay, so let's build and run and see what we have here. Okay, there we go. We have our green and blue. As you can see, we have our spacing here. So what I'm going to do now is comment this out. So our stack view's background color should be red. Okay, so now we are expecting that with the spacing we have this reddish line, but actually we don't, and that is because of the order that our stack view's background is basically rendered out. So what we are going to do next is create a UI stack view extension that will add a sublayer, a subview that will be basically our background, so we can add a background color to that view. So let's just stop this and do now. And I will create a new extension, a new file for this extension. Let's hit next here. I will create a UI stack view plus. Okay, let's import UIKit and type in extension UI stack view. Okay, so we are going to create a function called add background, and color will be the property and it will be a UI color. Okay, simple as that, and that should be it. Okay, so now let's create our subview. Let subview equals a simple UI view with the frame of the UI stack view's bounds. So now let's add our subview, the background color that we have just added here, and it will be a color. Let's add our subview auto resizing mask, and this will be array and dot flexible width and dot flexible height. And finally, let's insert our subview, and this is our subview at 0. Okay, and that is it for our extension. So let's hit command B, and now we can use this function. Let's go back to our root view controller and let's just comment this out and have stack view dot add a background color, and let's add in here a red. So let's build and run one final time, and now we should see under the spacing that we have this reddish background color. And that is it, how you can add a background color to a UI stack view. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell to get notified of new videos. Now it's your turn. Go ahead and comment down below, how would you use this UI stack view's background color extension in your own apps? I'm really eager to find out in the comments down below. So, as usual, I will see you in the next one.